صباح النور دكتور.
يلا راح نبدأ بالمحاضرة إن شاء الله. صورة واضحة يمكم؟
اي نعم دكتور.
Today the lecture about biology of the spine. بالبداية عادة لازم نتعرف على الطرق اللي ممكن نستخدمها لفحص السباين اللي هي البلين فيلم بعد لحد الآن ممكن نستخدم computed tomography, MRI with myelography also, isotopes previously can be used, and lastly myelography. It is all the procedure used for the imaging of the spine. The plain film usually used for the spinal trauma, and sometimes those who have backache used for degenerative spinal disease. But CT scan have great role for the anatomy, especially in the trauma, to detect the bony fragment. Detection of the intraspinal bodies and tumor for operative planning also. If we look for this picture, it is the brain x-ray of the cervical spine and of the lumbar. البوينتر واضح يمكم طلاب؟ بوينتر واضح؟
نعم دكتورة واضح.
هذه هو vertebral bodies. Intervertebral disc appear as lucent area between the vertebral bodies. This is the posterior element of the spine. If you look for this part of the lumbar spine, vertebral bodies and intervertebral disc and other vertebral body are the height of it decrease as a result of problem, as in the trauma with compression. Sometimes brain x-ray can be used for degenerative spinal disease. As you know, this is the radiolucent area for the intervertebral disc, and the lower part also radiolucent area for the intervertebral disc, but this space is narrowed as a sign of the degenerative spinal disease. This is the part of the computed tomography for the assessment of the spine. This is a sagittal view, vertebral body, intervertebral disc, vertebral bodies, lumbosacrovertebral bodies. This is the posterior element, and this is the part for the spinal cord and subarachnoid spaces. It is just a soft tissue with no details. This is a coronal view. It is a good view for the spine bodies. The 3D format of vertebral bodies and intervertebral discs with posterior element. This is also computed tomography showing as vertebral body in axial view. This is the body, and this is the part of the transverse process and the spinous process. And this is a part also, all of these transverse view of the vertebral bodies. Previously, we can use myelography. Myelography previously used on those patients who have problem in the spine. This is done by the lumbar puncture and injection of the contrast material. And after that, we use contrast material to design a subarachnoid spaces. This is the normal myelography and show this nerve root. It is a result of injection of the contrast in subarachnoid spaces and considered as invasive procedure. And patient may have allergy to the contrast media. Now it is replaced by MRI myelography. MRI myelography. The anatomy of the vertebral body, as you know, we have this part, vertebral body. We have the pedicles. We have a transverse process. We have spinous process. Anatomical view by plain x-ray, we have lateral view and we have anterior posterior view. In the lateral view, we can see this vertebral body is rectangular in the shape. This is the posterior element, and this is the spinous process, intervertebral disc in between. In the anterior posterior view also we have vertebral body, intervertebral disc, transverse lucent area. If you look for this part, I pointed it, this is the spinous process. And in anterior posterior view, important point to know is this, the circles related to the pedicles. واضحة هذه البيديكلز اللي راح نحكي عنها هواية بعدين. هاي اللي تشوفوها انه هي rounded circular areas at the periphery of the vertebra. This is the view of the pedicles in the anterior posterior view. If you look for this. هذه 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 هذه. Now the MRI is the preferred examination for the degenerative, inflammatory, and malignant condition. Because if you know, you have better soft tissue resolution than any other imaging modality. The normal appearance of the vertebral body by MRI, according to the part of the spine. In the body, as you know, it has fat context, so it is some sort of the brightness of the vertebral body in both T1 and T2. While, as you know, CSF, and intervertebral disc in T1, it is appear as a low signal intensity or hypo-intense. In T2, CSF is hyper-signal. If you look for this picture to the left side, anyone, أي واحد من عندكم أكو فد نقطة خلال الشرح ما يفهمها ممكن يحكي وياي. إذا شفونا هذه vertebral body to the hyper-intense. وهذا اللي بيناتهم الأسود هو شنو؟ الانترفيرتبرال ديسك. الانترفيرتبرال ديسك consists of the two parts, the nucleus bulbosus and annulus fibrosus. الانيولاس content of it as water, so to the bright. While annulus fibrosus is remain dark, hyper, hypo-intense signal. CSF is white. Spinal cord gray in color. This is a T2 weighted images. How you know it? By CSF white and the nucleus bulbosus bright. If you look for this picture, intervertebral discs remain black and CSF black. So the signal intensity important for degenerative disease is in T2. Because of the CSF content and because of the nucleus bulbosus fluid content. فإذا أحد يسألكم إنه إحنا إذا نريد نشوف degenerative disease وما عندنا وقت هواية وما عندنا أفلام نعطيها للبيشنت هواية فنفضل الـ T2 weighted images. Okay. What are the signs of the abnormalities in the spine? First of all, disc space narrowing, then collapse of the vertebral bodies, pedicle abnormalities, dense vertebra, lytic lesion within the vertebra, and paravertebral shadows. This is the most common signs visualized in the spine. As you know, we talked previously, the disc by blade film appears just as radiolucent area. It is have uniform height during the spine, except in the lumbar spine, it become thicker in the lower part of the spine, except at the level of the L1, L5, S1. If you look for this picture, this is the intervertebral disc, and this is the intervertebral disc area. What we see in this part, we see it is narrowed, just narrowed. This is the sign of the degenerative disease. But if you have, if you need more details of the degeneration and more detail of the disc itself, you show it by MRI. So disc space narrowing occur in degenerative spinal disease and in infection. We are talking the important point you must to know that disc space narrowing occur in the degenerative spinal disease and in the infection. If you look for this, the picture of the MRI, this is a normal disc, a normal disc, normal disc, normal disc. What happened in this part? Loss of the disc. This is the picture also, disc, 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 no disc here. Complete loss of the disc in this part of the spine. It is L4, L5 disc. Also this. So it occurs in infection and in degeneration. Disc space narrow. Second sign, it is collapsed vertebral body. I mean it is lost of the height of the vertebra. Could be occur in the normal bone, which are subjected to the stress as in the trauma, or could it occur also in abnormal bone previously, although the patient it have a tumor, secondaries, myeloma. When we look for this disc, if it is narrowed and see the medical, if it is stretched, any collapsed vertebra, you show it by MRI or by other imaging modality, you must to show the adjacent disc or the medical, because the differential diagnosis is well different. If you look for this plain X-ray, this is the vertebral body, this is the vertebral body, and if you look for this collapsed vertebral body, completely collapsed vertebral body, I mean decrease the height, and the disc is normal above it and below it. This is the MRI. If you look for the height of this vertebral body is decreased, and the height of this vertebral body also decreased. Those patients have secondaries. When you saw the collapsed vertebral body, you look for the adjacent disc. This is intact and this is intact, so that the picture goes with secondaries to the spine. This is another picture of the collapsed vertebral body by CT scan. Normal vertebral body. This is a decreased height. Normal, normal. Then this vertebral body with decreased height. Collapsed vertebral body could occur in the metastasis and in myeloma, but the disc should be normal. While in infection, the disc space is narrowing and the medical is intact. Sometimes the patient have osteoporosis and osteomalacia, so that this is the part of the spine become exposed to the collapsing. If you look for the generalized decrease of the bone density associated with the collapsed vertebra, but the medical is intact. And the disc also should be intact. In patient with the trauma also, the fractured in the vertebral body causing collapsing of the vertebral body. If you have collapsed vertebral body in children, you should suspect eosinophilic granuloma. If you have collapsed vertebral body in children without any history of other disease, you should suspect eosinophilic granuloma. The disc and the medical should be intact. The medical usually assessed by frontal view, but sometimes in the cervical view we required oblique view. Now we leave this part of the examination. We study by the computed tomography. Flattening and widening or the distance between the medical could be occur as a result of the neurofibroma and in the meningioma. If you look for this computed tomography, this is the vertebral body and this is the part of the medical. There's a large lytic lesion involving right side of the medical. This is the part of the medicals. And if you look for this, this is medical, medical, medical. But here, no medical. This is one sign of the secondaries to the spine, and intact disc. If you look for this MRI, vertebral body, and if you look this part, posterior part of the vertebral body and adjacent tissue with the hypo-intense mass involving this region as a result of the lesion involving this part of the spine. Other signs of the spinal disease including dense vertebral body, I mean it appear sclerotic. This is the normal density of the vertebral body, normal density, but if we look for this, it is sclerotic or more hyperdense than adjacent vertebral body, which occur in the metastasis as in patient with the prostate. It is important to know if you face the patient have sclerotic lesion anywhere in the body, anywhere in the bone, you must to put your in your mind prostatic carcinoma with metastasis could be occur in the 15% of the CA breast and also occur in the lymphoma and Paget disease associated with the increased volume of the that part of the body and also occur in the hemangioma. So the differential diagnosis secondaries from the prostate, lymphoma, Paget disease, hemangioma, and 15% or 10% of the CA breast with the sclerotic metastasis. If you look for this picture, this is vertebral body, vertebral body, vertebral, and this is sclerotic vertebra. This sclerotic vertebra. Another lesion occurring in the vertebral body is elliptic lesion. This vertebral body, vertebral body, vertebral body. If you look for this, there is a radiolucent area involving the anterior part of the vertebral body, which have a lot of the differential diagnosis could be secondaries, lymphoma, multiple myeloma, plasmacytoma, or infection if it is spread from the adjacent disc. Lytic lesion involving the vertebra by CT scan. This is a lytic lesion, destructive lesion involving the vertebral body. Now we talk about the trauma. The blade fill, now not commonly used, but sometimes previously used to show the fracture of the vertebral body or any part of the vertebral body. Alignment of the vertebral body is important to know. Or there is indirect sign of the fracture by detection of the paravertebral soft tissue swelling. We have anterior line, posterior line according to the ligament involving the vertebral body. And we have posterior spinal line, normal alignment of the vertebral body. If you look, we have vertebral bodies, intervertebral disc, pedicles, normal spinous process. This is a normal alignment of the vertebral body. So that if the fracture or the ligament disruption it is occur, it is important to know there is a stable or unstable spinal injury. How we know this is the trauma to reduce stable or spinal or unstable spinal injury? According to the division, we have anterior column of the vertebral body, including anterior part of the vertebral body. It is called anterior column. The middle part extending from the posterior third of the vertebral body to the posterior longitudinal ligament here. The third part from the posterior longitudinal ligament, including pedicle, lamina, and the spinous process. If the fracture or the trauma involving just anterior column, it is stable. Or if it is involving just posterior part, also it is stable. But if it is extending to the middle column, it is considered as unstable spinal injury. The stable and unstable spinal injury important in the management of the patient. Sometimes the mechanism of the injury is also important to detect the type of the trauma which occurred to the spine. We have hyperflexion injury, so that there is a compression of the anterior segment of the vertebral element, then the posterior segment will be distracted. May be associated with the fracture in the anterior inferior part of the vertebral body, produce flexion territorial fracture. If you look for this vertebral bodies, this is vertebral body. Look for this fracture part of the vertebra. fracture part of the vertebra, fracture part of the vertebra, it is called teardrop fracture. Another type of the injury, it is produced by hyperextension, also may be associated with the teardrop fracture. And this part of the injury usually associated with the cord injury. More severe hyperextension injury result in the part interarticularity fracture of the C2, which it is called Hagman fracture. If you look for this, as you know, the vertebral body of the spine, first and second, it is different structure from the other vertebral. If you look, we have Hagman fracture, so that the fracture in this ring. Any ring in the body, fracture in one side produce fracture in the other side. This is bilateral fracture. This is the part of the fracture, and this is the part of the fracture. On the bilateral view, this is the fracture, Hagman fracture. A blow to the head can result in the fracture of the C1. If you look for this C1, fracture from this part, fracture from this part, fracture from this part, also so that the fracture of the C1 vertebral body called Jefferson fracture. C2 called Hagman fracture. High energy trauma to this spine produced first fracture, destructive of the vertebra itself. This is associated with the posterior element part of the vertebra entering, or anterior part entering inside the spinal canal. As you know, the spinal canal containing the spinal cord and the nerve root. This is so difficult case. This is another pictures, collapsed vertebral bodies. Fracture involving vertebral bodies. This is also fracture, collapse. This is the screw angle to stabilize the vertebral body. If you look for this complete transection involving the cervical spine, and if you look for this fracture at the level of the disc associated with the displacement of the spine and severe compression of the spinal cord. لحد هنا عندكم سؤال طلاب؟ طلاب أحد
لا
يسمعني؟
شكرا دكتورة.
واضحة؟
نعم واضحة.
راح نبدأ.
واضح دكتور.
راح نبدأ موضوع degenerative spinal disease. مثل ما حكيت لكم بالبداية، we have vertebral body, we have intervertebral disc. Intervertebral disc consisting of the nucleus pulposus, which is high content of the water, appear hyper intense in T2. With aging, the water content of the disc is decreased, so that become hypo intense in signal also in T2. The sign of the degenerative spinal disease may be superadded by the osteoarthritic changes with the osteophyte formation, facet joint arthropathy may occur also, and this produce compression on the nerve root and on the exit foramen. If you look for this disc degeneration, this is a normal disc. Degenerated disc start by fissuring and decrease in the height. If you look at this part of the disc, it has become bulge. This is the part of the bulging. If you look for this part of the disc become herniated, the disc material goes outside the space, and if you look for this disc, it's completely thinned. This is the same picture, herniated disc, bulging disc, degenerated disc by fissure, decrease height of the disc. If you look for this, this is vertebral body. This is a normal signal intensity of the intervertebral disc, bright nucleus pulposus, hypointense. This one of the annulus fibrosis. If we look for this lower three intervertebral disc, the signal intensity changed, become hypointense as a result of the degeneration. Similar to this picture, normal discs, hypointense signal, hypointense associated with the bulging, posterior bulging of the disc. Biblation could be normal degenerative spinal disc or just narrow. Or sometimes we can see osteophyte formation. Narrowing osteophyte formation, associated osteoarthritic changes by sclerosis of the vertebral end plate. If you look for this CT scan, narrow disc sclerosis, air inside the joint, all are these features of the osteoarthritic changes. Disc herniation usually occur after degeneration of the disc, but sometime in young age group may occur after trauma. In old age, usually occur as a result of the degenerative spinal disease, while in young may present after trauma. Disc herniation usually occur in the loading area, which is our lower lumbosacral region. It could be vary in size from less than 2-5%, 25 to more than 25 to 50%. The disc may travel inside the spinal canal, good migrated disc, or sometime it will be separated from the parent disc and called sequestrated. This is again the picture of the bulging disc. Disc herniated to the spinal canal. If you look for this, this is a normal vertebral body and intervertebral disc. This disc, with the loss of the signal intensity, become hypo-intense as a result of the degenerative spinal disease. If you look for this disc, this is low intensity associated with the disc material migrated to the spinal canal. This is a disc herniation. Sometimes this herniation could be renamed according to the level and according to the direction. Could be central, this herniation could be lateral. This is detected by the axial view. If you look for the transverse view, this is a normal disc. From this part could be herniated to the left side. And if you look at this part of it, it's also four lateral side of the disc herniation. At this level, the disc herniation will affect the exit foramina and compressing the nerve root. Lumbar disc herniation usually occur at the L4, L5, L5 as well because of the loading area. And MRI have role in the detection of the recurrent disc after operation by adding the contrast. How we can differentiate it that the disc is recurrent or the pain of the patient related to the scarring after operation by giving the contrast. Recurrent disc does not enhance, while the scarring after giving the gadolinium, it will enhance. This is degenerated disc associated with the recurrent disc severely compressing the spinal canal. This is also herniated disc compressing the spinal canal and compressing the subarachnoid spaces. Spondylolisthesis is referred to the slipping of the vertebral body one over the other as a result of the trauma, as a result of the degenerative disease or defect in the pars interarticularis. It may be congenital or acquired. If you look for this alignment, this is the vertebral body. If you look for this part of the spine, it is not aligned with the upper vertebral body. Forward or backward, the sweeping of the sacrum. If you look for this, also no alignment, sacrum posterior and the vertebral body anterior. It is called spondylolisthesis. While spondylolysis, also there is a defect in the pars interarticularis, but no slipping. There is a defect. If you look for this yellow arrow, defect, but no slipping. Now we talk about important point of the infection. The gold standard of the infection of the spine involving the disc rather than other part of the body. Usually involving the disc and called discitis, it is usually hematogenous spread. Hematogenous spread. The hallmark is the destruction of the vertebral, intervertebral disc, and then reaching to the vertebral end plate, starting by narrowing of the disc with the erosion of the end plate. Then, if it becomes so severe, reaching to the other part of the vertebral body. By CT scan and imaging, we can show bone destruction, paravertebral abscess, and disc narrowing. But the MRI is the modality of the choice. If you look for this intervertebral disc, normal, normal, normal. When we reach to this part, there is a narrowing of the intervertebral disc. It may be occur in patient with degenerative. But according to the history, and according to the patient state, and according to the contrast we give, we can reach the final diagnosis. If we look for T2, also narrowing, after contrast study, there is enhancement of the site of the disc associated with the destruction in addition to the paravertebral soft tissue element. Paravertebral soft tissue element. If you look for this transverse process in homogeneous signal intensity of the all part of the vertebra as a result of the paravertebral soft tissue from the infection involving the disc. Another type of the infection of the vertebral body is a tuberculosis infection. The tuberculosis infection sometimes is different from other part of the infection, which it is produced by staph. And the tuberculosis sometimes the infection involving vertebral body before the disc. And the vertebral body, it is called collapse, produce angulation of the vertebral body, it is called gave us deformity, to produce kyphosis. This is the part of the spine with the kyphosis as a result of the complete collapse of the vertebral body associated with the paravertebral soft tissue deformity. This is the plain film showing us paravertebral soft tissue. The differential diagnosis of the paravertebral soft tissue, this is a soft tissue. This is part, this one, this one, this along the spine. The paravertebral soft tissue could be occur in the TB spine, could occur in the tumor, and could be occur in hematoma. In inflammatory spondyloarthropathy, we have ankylosing spondylitis, psoriasis, Reiter disease. Ankylosing spondylitis is an inflammatory process, usually symmetrical involvement of the sacroiliac joint with the spine. It must involve both sacroiliac joint and spine. The picture of this ankylosing spondylitis is by ossification of the ligament of the all part of the vertebra associated with the formation of the syndesmophyte. If you look for this spine, there is a complete fusion of the vertebral body. No finding of the intervertebral translucency associated with the ossification of the ligament. It is a produced spine in form of the bumbo spine. Bumbo spine, with العود الخيزران. كل تيكون شيء متصل بشيء. If you look for the MRI, this is the part of the syndesmophyte, complete ossification of the anterior longitudinal and posterior longitudinal ligament as a result of the syndesmophyte. Spina bifida refer to the defect in the spine. If you look for this opening, could be occulta. Nothing appear on the by clinical examination. Intact skin associated with the meningiocele or meningiomyelocele. This is the case of the scoliosis. one congenital anomaly of the spine. Spinal cord and equine compression could be occur as a result of the extradural lesion produced by myeloma and malignancy lymphoma infection, or extramedullary lesion in cases of the meningioma and the neurofibroma. It could be intramedullary as a result of the tumor of the spine itself. It is called ependymoma and astrocytoma. If you look for this masses involving spine, involving both vertebral body and compressing the spinal cord and subarachnoid space as a result of the secondary. While in this case, the tumor is involving the spinal cord itself covering this spine. In this case also, we have hyper-intense, well-defined, oblong-shaped mass involving the cord itself as a result of the tumor itself. In this case, we have degenerated spine compressing the spinal cord. In this case, we have abnormal signal intensity affecting the spine. So now we complete this lecture. You have any question? You have any question?
لا دكتورة.
زين خليكم موجودين على المنصة لا تطلعون من عندها. المحاضرة كلها واضحة؟ ما عندكم شيء؟ المحاضرة واضحة؟
نعم دكتور.
بس خليكم على المنصة حتى أشوف حضوركم. تقدرون تغادرون العلم.